There is one feature which is fairly striking in this case is that the funeral of the deceased was solemnized without any information to the police, and it is for this reason there appears to be neither any inquest report nor even a post-mortem report of the deceased full stop. This circumstance may mitigate against the husband, but there is nothing on record to indicate that the appellant was responsible for any such activity full stop. The prosecution has not led any such evidence complaining about the disposal of the dead body in the aforesaid manner to establish an intent on the part of the appellant to either obliterate the evidence or otherwise destroy it. The ocular testimony of Ram Kumar PW1 and Srimati Seema Devi PW2 is totally silent in this regard full stop. In such circumstances, any presumption against the appellant under any of the illustration of section 114 of the Indian Evidence Act would be impermissible as there is complete lack of evidence on this score full stop. The prosecution does not appear to have concentrated on this issue, which appears to be evident from the fact that family members of the deceased, including her mother-in-law, had reconciled, which also stands reflected in their statements made before the court full stop. Consequently, what we find, is that in the entire evidence of the prosecution, no element of mens rea arose to implicate the appellant for the having intentionally murdered the deceased full stop para. However, as indicated above, the factum of throwing the cloth soaked in kerosene causing injuries to the deceased is established from the dying declaration of the deceased full stop. The status of the dying declaration has already been held unimpeachable by us, as it is corroborated by the testimony of the Naib Tahsildar PW6 Ravi Kumar and PW9 Dr. Dilip Kumar Rai full stop. In such circumstances, we are of the opinion that the appellant had the knowledge, if not the intention, to the extent that her action is likely to cause death of the deceased in the ordinary course of things full stop. The nature of the injuries and the background in which the same came to be suffered by the deceased on account of a clear overt act of the appellant convinces us to accept that the prosecution has established the offense, but only to the extent as defined in part 1st of section 304 IPC full stop. The prosecution, in our opinion, to that extent has succeeded in traveling the distance through its evidence from must have been to must be in the present case, and the appellant had such knowledge so as to cause death when she committed the offense full stop. There is, as recorded above, a complete lack of evidence, beyond reasonable doubt, about the intention of the appellant to commit murder of the first degree full stop. Our conclusion to that extent, is not an alternative opinion but the only possible view, and therefore we are unable to accept the view taken by the trial court full stop.